Hello everyone. The stomach is the muscular organ that lies on the left side of the upper abdomen and responsible for receiving food from the esophagus and breaking it down for digestion. It secretes acid and enzymes, contracts periodically, and churns food to enhance digestion of food. Today's topic is about one of the most critical diseases of the stomach, the stomach cancer. Hi, I'm Ume, and before we start, please subscribe to our channel so the next time you will be updated with our new releases. So what is stomach cancer? The general concept of cancer is the abnormal growth and uncontrollable division of cells in a certain organ. So stomach cancer is a cancer that starts in the stomach. Stomach cancer, also known as gastric cancer, can affect any part of the stomach. The human stomach is subdivided into four parts. Although stomach cancer can affect any part, in most of the world, stomach cancer arises from the main part of the stomach body. However, in the United States, stomach cancer highly likely occurs where the esophagus meets the stomach, an area known as the gastroesophageal junction. The location of cancer in the stomach is a factor that doctors consider when preparing a treatment plan. Our role today is to answer most of your questions regarding stomach cancer. Today we have Dr. Lee, who is a leading doctor at Hanyang University Hospital in Seoul. He's going to discuss with us about stomach cancer from an experienced medical point of view. So, Dr. Lee, what is exactly gastrocolonoscopy and how often should it be done?
We usually do gastroscopy and colonoscopy when we do checkups. A gastroscopy is a test that looks at the esophagus, stomach, and duodenum by inserting the endoscope into your mouth. And you can do this just by fasting for one meal. Colonoscopy is a test that looks at the entire large intestine by inserting an endoscope through the anus. This test requires you to take medicine the day before, inducing diarrhea to empty out the intestine. So that's the basic method. You are usually recommended to do gastroscopy once every 2 years. And it is said that colonoscopy usually needs to be examined every 4 to 5 years.
How about the early signs of stomach cancer?
Stomach cancer usually has early cancer and advanced cancer. In the early stages of stomach cancer, there are typically no symptoms. So it can be said that early cancer has no symptoms. When the cancer progresses on to stage 3 and 4, you can get stomach aches, indigestion, weight loss. These symptoms can occur. The important point is that there are no symptoms in the early stages.
So what kind of examinations are needed to detect stomach cancer?
First, the most important thing is the endoscopy. It's most important that you do an endoscopy. As I said earlier, there are no symptoms at the beginning, so you can't tell whether you have cancer in your stomach or not through symptom detection. So the most important thing is gastroscopy. Diagnosis should be done at an early stage, as the treatments will work well and will have a good outcome. Getting into a habit of receiving endoscopy every 2 years is important.
In Korea, the medical checkup system is well made, so they run tests for everyone in the whole country every 2 years.
So it is said that it's important to have a checkup once every 2 years like that.
How about in the case of stomach cancer, what kind of surgeries are there?
We can divide stomach cancer into early gastric cancer and advanced gastric cancer. Of course, advanced gastric cancer requires surgery. So you can open the abdomen to remove the stomach, or in some cases, you can cut a hole in the abdomen and insert a laparoscope to cut the stomach.
However, in the case of early gastric cancer, it is in its early stages.
In this case, only endoscopic lesions and gastric cancer lesions can be cut out with an endoscope by inserting an endoscope into the mouth. Because that is possible, depending on the progression of the disease. We usually decide whether to perform surgery or cut with an endoscope.
So, Professor Lee, how many people get stomach cancer every year? And from these people, how many are 100% cured?
Worldwide, it is said that 200,000 people develop stomach cancer per year. And when you look at Korea alone, there are about 30,000 people per year. So it's a very common cancer in the world as well as in Korea. In Korea, the treatment works well, but usually stomach cancer patients have a survival rate of about 5 years. But if you look at the data in Korea, the 5-year survival rate is up about 70%. It means that if there are 100 stomach cancer patients, 70 of them will live longer than 5 years. And this is because we can give an early diagnosis. So, before there are any symptoms, when examined, it is detected and are usually all in the early stages. When the examination is done after symptoms occur, most of the time it is already past stage 3. So even if there are no symptoms, it is detected in the early stages through regular examination. And this is why we have a high survival rate of stomach cancer in Korea.
When we deal with cancer, we can look at them from stages, early stage and developing stages. During the early stage of stomach cancer, there are no symptoms mostly. When the cancer develops and enters the third and fourth stage, there is stomach pain. Digestion is difficult and weight loss. These symptoms can appear, but the important point is that in the early stage, there are no symptoms. The most important examination is gastroscopy. And like we said before, since there are no symptoms in the early stage, it is hard to detect the cancer through symptoms. So the most important tool is to perform gastroscopy. It is easier to treat early since it's more successful. It is important to get gastroscopy every 2 years. In Korea, everyone is provided with gastroscopy every 2 years as the infrastructure is well set up. It is devised to undergo such exams every 2 years. If we look at the entire world, there are about 200,000 cases per year. If we look at Korea alone, it is about 30,000 cases per year. So, it is a common form of cancer in both the world and Korea. The 5-year survival rate for Korea is about 70%. So, if we have 100 patients undergoing the surgery, about 70 people will live past the 5-year mark. The reason is due to early detection through exam. We catch before there are any symptoms as part of the overall exams. In such cases, they are almost all early stage. If we catch it after there are symptoms, they are mostly stages 3 or later. So Korean stomach cancer treatment success is based on early detection. Thank you for joining us in yet another video covering key health-related topics with Cloud Hospital TV. If you have any questions or comments, please leave it below and we'll respond to you as soon as possible.